Welcome once again. Right now we're 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verses 26, all the way through to the end of the chapter, verse 40, orderly worship. Paul says, "What is it then, brothers? When you come together, each one of you has a psalm, a song, has a teaching, has a revelation, has another language, or has an interpretation. Let all things be done to build each other up." Paul puts a great emphasis on building one another up. And that's more than just patting one another on the back. That is really building one another up in the Spirit, building one another up in the knowledge of God, in the knowledge of the Scriptures. "If any man speaks in another language, let it be two, or at the most three, and in turn, and let one interpret. But if there is no interpreter, let him keep silent in the assembly, and let him speak to himself and to God. Let the prophet speak, two or three, and let the others discern." Even Paul, in the heat of revival, right after Jesus rose from the dead and ascended, even he says, you've got to discern. You've got to really judge and test the prophecies. You might say, how do we judge? How do we test the prophecies? Check out the previous session. We talked all about it. "But if a revelation is made to another sitting by, let the first keep silent. For you all can prophesy one by one, that all may learn." It's important to learn. "And all may be exhorted. The spirits of the prophets are subject to the prophets." That is a wonderful, wonderful truth right here. The spirits of the prophets are subject to the prophets. I was at a meeting before, and you know, the Spirit of God really was moving. And, you know, the preacher that was up in the pulpit said, okay, everybody quiet, everybody still, no sound at all, you know, and they quenched everything that was going on there. And when everybody was quiet and still like dead, then the preacher up there said, see, they can control it. That's not God. No, listen. The spirits of the prophets are subject to the prophets. "For God is not a God of confusion, but of peace, as in all the assemblies of the saints. Let the wives be quiet in the assembly, for it has not been permitted for them to be talking except in submission, as the law also says." That is in Deuteronomy chapter 27, verse 9. "If they desire to learn anything, let them ask their own husbands at home, for it is shameful for a wife to be talking in the assembly. What? Was it from you that the word of God went out? Or did it come to you alone? If any man thinks himself to be a prophet or spiritual, let him recognize the things which I write to you, that they are the commandment of the Lord." You see, here, Paul made it clear. What he says here is the commandment of the Lord. Back in chapter 7, he made it clear. What he says there is not the commandment of the Lord, not the word of the Lord, okay? So that really flies in the face. I kind of like to rub it in every once in a while to some of these Christians that think that every single word of Paul is the word of God. It's not. Paul actually said it explicitly. It's not. And if you want more information on that, check out 1 Corinthians chapter 7. "But if anyone is ignorant, let him be ignorant. Therefore, brothers, desire earnestly to prophesy, and don't forbid speaking with other languages or other tongues. Let all things be done decently and in order." And you know, sometimes when you have a church service and God is really moving in that church service, if you're having a meeting, even if it's in your own home or in a large building, let God move. And having things done decently and in order doesn't necessarily mean what you think it might mean. It doesn't necessarily mean everybody is as quiet as a cemetery. You can have the order of a nursery. You can be decently and in order in a nursery and still noisy, and it's still decently and in order, okay? So in your church, don't make it a cemetery, okay? I mean, some people, they can get excited when they hear the word of God. God can move on people and do wonderful things, but let it be decently and in order. Seek God with all your heart, and if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will amaze you and show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.